Hello everybody, greetings from Turkey. I'm Mirç Büyükkoyuncu and I'm a mechanical engineer. Today we are going to make an optimization project. In this project we will have a stiffened plate and there will be 7 stiffeners. We will optimize this stiffened plate by optimizing plate thickness, and stiffener height. Also we will make this optimization against buckling problem. And we will follow the linear buckling solution procedure. Because in the nonlinear buckling analysis, it takes a lot of time to optimize. We don't need nonlinear problem to understand the optimization tool of ANSYS. So in this project, we will try to increase the critical buckling load for a constant mass. Without changing the first mass, we will increase the buckling load with the help of the optimization tool. Actually, we will try to increase the load factor because in the eigenvalue buckling analysis, given force is multiplied by the load factor to reach the critical buckling load. I mean, when you apply the force, eigenvalue buckling analysis tool increase or decrease your load to reach the critical buckling value. Therefore, it doesn't matter how much force you apply. When you are doing linear buckling analysis, it's going to be multiplied anyway. Before we start, I need to say that we already validated our modeling methods by comparing with the published articles. So we are sure our modeling method is correct, so we can model this buckling problem correctly. Let me introduce our stiffened plate. There will be 7 stiffeners connected to the plate, and the plate dimensions will be 1 meter, 1 meter, and 3.5 millimeter thickness. Stiffener dimensions are 1 meter length and 30 millimeter height, also 3 millimeter thickness. According to these dimensions, our total mass will be nearly 11.44 kilograms. And as I said before, there will be 7 stiffeners, and this stiffener is located at the middle of the plate. So the other stiffeners will be 145 millimeters far away. So let's continue with the boundary conditions. In this case, our top and bottom edges will be clamped. So that means displacement in the Z direction will be restrained, and also rotation of X and rotation of Z will be restrained. For the left and right edges, they will be simply supported. So that means displacement in the Z direction will be restrained, and also rotation of X will be restrained. At the same time, there are two compressive forces acting on the top and bottom edges that causes buckling. So let's continue with the ANSYS workbench. First of all, let's start with the static structural. Right click on the engineering data and say edit. We are gonna use the same aluminium alloy with the previous videos. And please add the aluminium alloy. So we are going to make some changes in the properties. Young's modulus will be that value. Tensile yield strength and compressive yield strength will be 324. The ultimate strengths are 471 megapascal. We can close it. So right click on the geometry and say new design modular. So design modular is opened. So click on the XY plane and then click on the new sketch. go to the sketching. And firstly, we are going to sketch the plate. So units will be in millimeter. Go to the dimensions. Let's define the dimensions. So our plate will be 1 meter and 1 meter. That's why every piece of the dimensions will be 500 millimeter. I'm trying to do the middle of the plate will be located at the origin. I want to make it. I will explain it later. So to sketch the stiffeners, please select the YZ plane and click on the new plane. Say generate and left click on the plane for and then click new sketch. I'm sorry, we need to edit the plane for. There will be a transformation. And we say offset Y. And that will be 1.75 millimeter. So before we start, go to the concept and surface from sketches. Click on the sketch one and say apply. That will be our base plate. It will be 3.5 millimeter thickness. So our plate thickness is 3.5 millimeter. We need to make an offset for the stiffeners as half of the plate thickness according to the shell theory. That's why we did that, because of that. So we are going to sketch the stiffeners. Go to the sketching and select the rectangle, but don't forget to make the coincident with the new plane. Don't make coincident with the first coordinate system. It will be wrong. It should be coincident with the plane 4. And go to the sketching again. Let's define the dimensions. Length of the stiffener will be 1 meter, so they are 500 millimeters. And what was the stiffener's thickness? 30 millimeter. The height will be 30 millimeters. Go to the concept and say surface from sketches. Please select sketch 2 and say apply. The stiffener thickness will be 3 millimeters and say generate. So our middle stiffeners is sketched. So we will create the pattern to copy the stiffeners. Please select the stiffeners as a geometry and you can select the direction by clicking the edges. The offset will be 145 millimeter and there will be 3 copies for the left of the plate. So let's continue with the right of the plate and select the stiffener. So say generate. So our plate is ready. We can continue with the mechanical part. So right click on the model and say update. So right click on the model and say edit. First of all, let's define the material properties. Okay, we will choose the aluminium alloy, and we need to define the connection. Our connection type will be bonded, so select the stiffener base face as a target and select the stiffener edges as a contact. Apply. You can make top. Just see the blue paint near to the stiffeners. And also we are going to define the coordinate system. I'm going to explain it later why we are doing this. Defined by global coordinates, and that will be 500. So it's defined here. I will explain it later. So let's continue with the mesh. We can choose the size function as a uniform. In the plates, that will be very good because plates are already rectangular square. Our mesh is ready and it seems good. So, as you remember from the previous videos, we choose the boundary conditions, we choose the nodes, we define them as like this. And we right click on the nodes and create name selection. But in the optimization tool, we are not going to do that because we are selecting the nodes actually manually by one by one. So when we optimize the height or the length, the properties and nodes will be changed. So ANSYS cannot catch this change because we select them by one. We select them manually. So we need to define them more numerically, let's say. So we are going to continue with the worksheet. Please click on the top and bottom nodes. Scoping method will be worksheet. So we want to make the we want to select the top and bottom edges nodes. To do that, please right click on the page and say add row. Entity type will be mesh node. Criterion will be location Y. Operator will be range. So please enter the lower value as a 500, upper bound is a -500, and the top and bottom edges nodes will be selected automatically. So let's continue with the other nodes. Now I'm going to add row and I will select the left and right edges nodes. So now you will choose the location of X, and that will be range again. So as you can see, the left and right edges are selected. If we change the length of the plate, these are going to be selected again. So now I want to choose the node that is located at the middle of the plate. So to choose the middle node, I will use the distance and operator will be range. It will be actually the distance between the middle node and the global coordinate system is zero, but sometimes when we are doing meshing, the mesh size will be different from each other, so the middle of the node will be located at the near of the global coordinate system. So we are defining a tolerance value, we can say that 3 millimeter. Our mesh is already 20 millimeter, that will be very low value. So click generate and the middle of the node will be selected. At the same time I want to select the node that is in the same line with the middle node, and that will be here. So to define it, go to the worksheet again and say add row. Entity type will be mesh node, criterion will be distance, operator will be range. We are gonna define the tolerance again, but this time we are using the new coordinate system we created to make this one. And as you can see, this node is selected. So why are we doing that? Because in the buckling analysis we didn't fix any of the edges, so at least one of the edges should be fixed, because plate can move right now. But we will fix these two nodes, and that creates a line here, and this line cannot go to the anywhere, so therefore the buckling will be symmetric and the plate cannot move to the anywhere. If you don't do that, you are gonna get errors. I will show you that. So let's continue with the boundary conditions. First of all, we are going to define the top and bottom edges boundary conditions. That was the clamped and Z component will be zero. And the rotation of X and Z will be fixed, and rotation Y will be free. So let's rename them. Left and right nodes. Middle node. Okay, we rename them to see them easily. Let's continue with the left and right edges boundary condition. We are gonna create nodal displacement and nodal rotation. Okay. What was the boundary condition? UZ and rot X. UZ will be 0 and rotation Y and Z will be 3. So we are choosing left and right. So I'm going to define the middle node. The X and Y component will be 0 because we want to keep it in the middle, but it can buckle in the Z direction, as you understand. Also, we want this node in the near of the middle node. You can define the X, but it doesn't matter anyway. And we need to define the force as a line pressure. Please choose the single select and let's begin with the top of the plate. Please select the stiffeners edges and plates edges. Oops, I choose them wrongly. Okay, let's do that like this. Apply. 8 edges will be selected and that will be component in the minus y direction. It can be 100 newton. So the other compressive force will be in the bottom edges. Say apply. And that will be 100 newton. So as you can see, our forces are defined. So before we analyze it, let's add the eigenvalue buckling. Please carry it to the solution of the static structural and drop it. And go to the mechanical again. Okay, the buckling is here right now. We want to see the total deformation in the static structural and the worm misses stresses strain and also worm misses stresses. In the buckling problem, we want to see the total deformation. So let's solve this. So it's solved. It takes couple of minutes. Solve it. Our shape, our colors, our buckle type is very good. As you can see, this is the shape that we expected. So we solved the buckling problem and we decided the some dimensions, as you remember here, but we don't know if they are the best dimensions or not. So we need to understand which dimensions will be best for us. So first of all, our plate thickness can be changed. I want to change it. So I need to add parameters, the thickness. Please add thickness to the parameters. And also that was the base plate, and also I want to add the stiffeners thickness to the parameters and to select all of them easily. Okay, the all of them is added to the parameters. Also I want to make the load multiplier maximum, so I'm gonna add the load multiplier to the parameters. At the same time, I want to make the mass constant. Therefore, I will add the mass to the parameters. I will keep it constant. So, while we are doing that, we can change the stiffener height, right? So, that was the stiffener height. We can add it to the parameters. Let's call it height. But don't forget about that there will be a distance between the stiffeners and plate, as the half of the base plate's thickness. So we define it here 1.75 because the R plate thickness was 3.5 millimeters. So we need to add to the parameters, because when the plate thickness change, that should be changed also. Let's call it distance. Okay, I added everything meaningful to the parameters and go to the workbench, and the parameter set will be located at the workbench. Right click on the parameter set and say edit. So there are the, you can see the parameters that we define. So that was the base plate. These are the stiffeners and this is height. So there is an expression to define the stiffeners. I will change it because I want to make the all stiffeners thickness the same. How can I do that in the ANSYS? I will define the expression with the same the first stiffener. So this is the if first stiffener's thickness is 4 millimeter, that is going to be 4 millimeter. So I'm going to apply this for every stiffeners. P2. Otherwise ANSYS can make all of the stiffeners thickness different. We don't want it. Okay, total deformation multiplier, load multiplier is a output parameter and also master output parameter. Okay, they are all right. So let's continue with the design exploration, and please carry this response surface optimization to the system and drop it. And right click on the design of experiments and say edit. So in here, so I deleted properties, therefore I need to go to the right here, click on the properties and that's going to come again. So when you click the surface body thickness, you can see the lower bound and upper bound. It's created by ANSYS randomly. So we are going to change. I want to make it the lower bound 2 millimeter. This is for the plate. So upper bound will be 4 millimeter. In the optimization, ANSYS is going to search for these bounds. So for the stiffeners, the range will be much 2 to 20. So also there is an height. I want to make it between 20 and let's say 60. Okay, the distance. Distance will be half of the base plate thickness, so it's going to be. Oh, okay, I forgot something. Let's go to the project and right click on the parameter set. And there's the distance. It should be the half of the plate thickness. So we are going to define it as a half of the plate thickness, P1 over 2. Okay, so we don't define it. And please say refresh and say edit again. As you can see, we cannot define it. So let's check them. And yes, 2 to 20, 2 to 4, 20 to 60. Okay. So we are updating the design of experiments. Right click on the design of experiments, say update. It probably takes much time, like 30 minutes, I guess. So please wait. So design of experiments are ready after 30 minutes. Let's check. There are some design points are created by ANSYS between the our boundaries. So we can close it and go to the response surface and say edit. And we can check the bounds again to be sure. And right click on the response surface and say update. That will be quicker. So update is done. There is a min-max search. That means when you click the, for example, load multiplier, you can find the minimum calculated and maximum. So also for the mass, the minimum and maximum, we don't want these one, so we can close it and we can refresh the optimization and right click up the optimization and say edit. Right now we are going to make an optimization. Please click on the objectives and constraints. So what are we gonna do right now? I want to keep the mass constant, and also I want to make the load multiplier maximum. Therefore I need to define them in the ANSYS. So let's choose the mass. Okay, let's close it. Choose the mass and let's define a bound as 4. Okay. Okay, first I need to define the upper bound. Actually, let's make it. And there will be a little tolerance. So let's go to the load multiplier. And we want to make it maximum. So these are enough for our study. So also when you click the property, there is an option decision support process. You can select the importance of the case. For example, maximization is for important for us, so importance can be higher. Actually it doesn't matter for our case. So right click on the optimization and say update. The optimization is done, but before we check the results, let's make a quick reminder and let's go to the model. And as you remember, our load multiplier was 1.8 for the 11.44 kilogram plate. So we change and we optimize the dimensions without changing the mass. So let's check the results in the optimization parts. There's a candidate points in the below the results. Click it. And candidate point 1 is the best result always. Go to the load multiplier and the maximum load multiplier is 5.1 nearly. Actually 3 times better from our solution. The mass is 11.44 and there are another options, these are very different from each other, but the best one is this. So in the best one, the plate thickness is 3.3 millimeters, and the stiffeners are 2 millimeters, stiffeners thickness are 2 millimeters, and the height of the stiffener is 55 millimeters. The other points are really different from each other, but the best value is this one. So thank you for watching the video. If you have any questions, you can ask me in the comments. So if you like the video, please press the like button. Have a nice day, guys. Thank you.